Hello, greetings. This is Gilles Mancio. I thought I'd come and say hello, wish you a good day. We are moving through this process of coming here to speak about those spiritual things that are not yet completely understood or talked about in the media, for instance. For very soon, I know me and many other people will all be called to move into, for this channel is kind of intimate, it's for a few hundred people. But there is this information will have to come into the collective consciousness and utilizing the media to reach millions of people, to prepare them, to inform them of the eternal and infinite nature, to know that they are multidimensional beings, and so then for the, it is we'll soon need to inform the world on that. And so I'm going to pull a few cards to see what's coming this week, for we are moving closer to a full moon in Aquarius. That will be a very powerful moon. So, and we have the same cards as in French, almost the same cards. Amazing. I mix the cards, I get the same card. So it is because it is what it is. For this early week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, what we're going through is like we're evacuating all fear of failure, fear of success, fear of all kinds of things. For the fear, we have to love, say, I love you, to a fear, and it will be dismissed. And so it is the card here, it's the Tower of Casanova. It's kind of a funny, humoristic tower, or erotic a little bit. On Wednesday, Thursday, we will be confronting all the doubts, for we have to eliminate all doubts, all fear. Once again, doubt is a dead center, but we have to self-determine to overcome all those little things. And at the end of the week, towards this weekend, it is the night of Pentacle. It is a night that is moving with the globe of consciousness into something that is wanted, that has a full control of the direction. It is a slow progress, but it is always going in one direction, which is towards the realization of the highest good, of our own highest good and the highest good of all. So, because right now there is the tower, everything that's not in alignment in the early week, this week, everything that's not in alignment with the divine will has to be censured. So we want to let go of the attachment of towards the old ways. And towards the middle of the week, there's going to be some income that is coming, potential for success and money and so on. This will definitely enhance our. For here, it is more. It is a man that's observing a woman, but it is. Traditionally, the Six of Pentacles is the card that is announcing a financial gain. So it is all very good. It is all very positive. We have to let go of doubts and already move into this situation of receptivity. For this full moon will be in Aquarius, and it's a very powerful moon. For Aquarius, it's the most universe, very universal. When the Leo, the Sun in Leo, will be, it's very individual. It's our own passion. And this moon will be enlightened by Venus, for there will be a conjunction with Venus in Leo. And Venus is our preference, is our passion, is our finance, is our preference, is the manifestation of things. And this manifestation will be supported by the fact that Jupiter is going direct, and Jupiter has been going backwards since April, I believe, in retrograde. When the planet is retrograde, it internalizes the process. When it goes forward, it externalizes the process. So most planets are more powerful when they go direct, except for Chiron. Chiron, being an internal planet, the wounded healer, when it goes retrograde, it becomes even more powerful. But so there is a Jupiter that will be going direct, that will accelerate the manifestation, while at the same time there is making a square to Neptune, which is confronting our dreams. While at the same time Uranus will be in Taurus, will be going retrograde, so we will force humanity to address their own inner values. Uranus is the unexpected, and so there may be unexpected event in terms of what is going on, and yet Saturn will remind us of our responsibility. The Sun will be moving through Leo with Venus, and then the Sun is going to meet Mars, and then Venus is going to meet Mars. So it's going to be very much the blending of our desire and our will come together. So it is quite wonderful, and there is this diamond light that will be coming down. That's a bit of astrology, and so there's a potential for amazing manifestation. I want to say that it's very important to respect our own beliefs. whatever we believe, we have to respect it until we see that something, a belief, no longer serves us, then we disconnect it and replace it by a higher belief. So it is important to let go of the old beliefs in order to adopt new ones, and yet returning to, there is this eternal, this center, we can call an eternal center, where we can always return within ourselves, where we know that we do not know, and from there we can receive the information. When we do not know, it's no use to pretend that we know. It is better to know that we don't know and ask for this to return to the void. For to know that we do not know is the closest thing we can ever get to the truth. For the truth is something that is eternally shifting and change. The truth doesn't change, but our perception of it is always evolving. And for all of this will lead to an inner revolution, but we have to let go of the idea of revolt and emotional reaction to things. We have to we are led to this self empowerment, to this acceptation, to this mysticism, understanding that there is this we have this inner core that does not change, that is our higher self, our God self, but yet the flow. We are also the flow. We are the evolution of life. All of life transmutes through us at all time. All planets, all galaxies, all things. We are made of every state. We are aware of that. Of course, we are limited to whatever level of consciousness, but we are opening up to all amazing new energies, and this flow of life that is us, that we are experiencing, is in eternally changing. Our condition, temporal condition, will always change. So if they're just transitional, so if they're negative, we're going to transmute them into positive. But if they're positive, we want to make this transition. They will change, no, even if they're positive, but we want to make it even more positive. So. And we have the power to direct that, to transmute the darkness, to assist the good, and to decipher between what is which is which. For there is a part of us that is agitated and part of us that is serene. We want to move from agitation to serenity. Serenity is wisdom, to be able to be above all triggers. And so this is what the nirvana, the serenity and lucidity in all circumstances, for this is the outcome of salvation, to find this true wisdom of being serene. But understanding within the Creator, within God, there is infinite agitation and infinite serenity. God is eternally changeless, and yet it is in all state. His agitation is beyond our conception. He's moving through all things at all times. So eventually we need to integrate this inner center and understand the outer flows as well, to move between action and non-action, to find the harmonious connection between action and non-action. And yet remaining serene, understanding the flow of things. Also, when I said that the galactic portals are always open, the Sirian portals is always open all year long. It is just at this particular time there is a greater influx of energy and concentration. So as people concentrate their energy collectively, it emphasizes this side of the portal and it allows those on the other side to bring more energies. But those portals are always open. For the Syrian doorway is the royal feline race, the guardians of the portal, but we cannot bring fear of shadows inside the portals. And there is nothing to fear. In truth, we are, when we sleep, we have a double life. We're already visiting the ships or the planets. We are doing so much that we do not know, and we have the means by which to communicate because of our dream, by dreams. Sometimes we have nightmares. Those are times where we expurge, we let go of darker energy we had within ourselves that we do not want to experience in physical plane. But when our dreams are positive, take notes, because the dreams are messenger. There is many dreams, not the nightmares, but the other ones, the positive, beautiful dreams. Take notes. Do not forget those dreams. They are messages sent by the soul. For the on Arcturus, for instance, is a star system that is, you can find it in the Big Dipper, and if you draw a line, it's like a Dipper, and you draw a line, you find the system of Arcturus, a big blue bright stars. There are 15 inhabited planets and hundreds of moons that are all inhabited there, and those systems have never been in war, never been in conflict. They even have third dimensional civilization, physical biological beings that live on Arcturus for experimenting biological life, but they don't have this shadow aspect. They're completely pure. They do not have this this they never came into this rebellion against God or anything, so they don't have this darker illusionary aspect. And so you do want to connect to the Arcturian fourth dimension, fifth dimension, sixth dimension, seven, eight, nine dimension. Essentially, they are the guardian of the fifth dimension. The tunnel of Arcturus is the light that when we die, we have to go through that tunnel, but they're essentially on the ninth dimension. But even fourth dimensional Arcturians, they are very contactable. They all they're very wise and very kind, and so you can there is no just all extraterrestrial wants to be connected from heart to heart on a one-to-one basis. They do not want to feel that you don't feel that you are inferior or that you're superior. It is the only proper relationship, even to God, is on an equal basis, understanding that God is far more, for it's the source of all that is. But even there, it's like it's an equal partnership. We have to keep the balance between to respect ourselves enough to know that we are created in the image of God. And all the extraterrestrials do not want to come to the earth. If humans would consider it as God and would submit themselves to them, they have to wait that human is as matured enough to see them as equal. Although the higher you are in consciousness, the more you have to respect the wisdom that has those and the ignorance that has those who are below. But your relationship to God, no one can teach you that relationship. You have to create that relationship. It's like no one can eat for you or can sleep for you. You have to do that for yourself. And no one can always follow your own intuition, always follow your own inner self, your own guidance rather than outer guidance. And so I wanted to rebound on to say this relationship to God cannot be ascertained from an intellectual. It's not an intellectual pursuit. It is more than an experience. God is no idol. It's the only thing that is real. And just put your hand on your heart and feel it. Feel your presence of God within yourself and develop that little by little. It is something that it takes time to align, because you have to be patient, not because it does take time, but because there is resistance to that. And right now we're passing through the fourth dimension, and we're going to be moving towards the fifth dimension. And we want to achieve that fifth dimension, that point of freedom. I was talking about the technology yesterday. I don't mean to say that follow your own intuition. If you feel like getting a connected object in your home, to use that, just use it. It's all for good. It's all part of the process. But in a sense, when we depend too much on electronic, we are bombarded with lower frequency that prevents us from accessing the inner connection to our light body. And so, but follow your intuition. There is no, there are people that want to implant computer chips in their brain, and this will actually prevent them from the opening of their DNA. Those people that are the transhumanists will not be able to achieve the ascension, because those lower programming, mortal program, and somebody else will control their chips as well. So they become like robotic. As soon as someone pushes the button, they will go online into the wheel of somebody else. But I'm not criticizing that, just for the human and the universe might put an end to this programming. Yet those programs also have some lighter side, some advantages for some people in medicine, for instance. Some people that have very heavy handicap could be benefited from having implants that will assist them to get a better quality of life. So all those things I'm talking about are not they're just a direction, they're just ideas, they're just thoughts. For all technologies were supposed to serve humanity, and every negative, for there was many negative technologies, some of them will be completely abandoned, like machines of wars that will eventually completely disappear, fall into dust, be forgotten forever. But we'll only have defensive sonic weapons, so to speak, to protect ourselves when we move into the ascension, if there is still need. But all the negative technology, like particle accelerator and all those things, will be transmuted to serve humanity in some ways. So all the dark, everything that is dark, will be transmuted into light, which will become return to the service of life. all the dark creation has had to go through the whole process, so everybody sees their own creation. Soon the light and the dark will be seen, and so there will be nowhere to run. Everything will be clear. But for it has to be revealed for those who have created this darkness, needs to see the result of their creation. But we need to always forgive, because if we do not, we move into the love of the one, the inner connection, we forgive, and otherwise we are drawn to karmic timelines where we have to reincarnate to see that those who have done wrong get punished, and it's an eternal process. The same thing with the old dogmas of the religion. I'm not saying to tune in to those gods, Adonai, Yahweh, Sophia, Allah. Those are wonderful divine beings of eternal Krishna, Brahma, Lord Buddha, or ascended masters, or for their all in assistance to humanity to evolve. But the true connection will come from within. It is by tuning into the inner divinity that we'll find our salvation. Otherwise, when we do have a bad life, we reincarnate to pay the karma of our life. If we had a good life, then we reincarnate to harvest the spiritual merits. But we'll never find freedom. We'll always be in eternal in the samsara. So we want to free ourselves, and for that, follow your inner guidance, your inner creator. That will your creator will lead you there. Trust your inner guidance more than anything else. Well, I think that is what I wanted to discuss today. I hope you have a wonderful week. For this week, we'll evacuate all kinds of old programming, and that by the weekend we should find a great deal of joy and freedom. That is all kinds of manifestation, abundance. Venus can bring manifestations of abundance into our life. So we are in gratitude and stay focused on that as much as possible. The paintings behind me, this is like an interior. It's kind of a Mondrian energy. It's got those crossing lines. It's kind of subtle. And there's those two paintings, a green dominated green and red. And here is a painting of astronomy. One of the first I made. This was the most difficult to solve. But it's very, very subtle. I really like it. I'm going to finish with a song and then pull a last card for the Archangel, a song that went through my name, my head. It's called A Horse With No Name. On the first part of the journey, I was looking at whole of life. There were plants and birds and rocks and things. There was sand and hills and rings. The first thing I met was a fly with a buzz and the sky with no clouds. The heat was hot and the hot ground was dry, but the air was full of sound. I've been through the desert on a horse with no name. It feels good to be out of the rain. In the desert you can't remember your name, cause there ain't no one for to give you no pain. La 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 la. After 2 days in the desert sun, my skin began to turn red. After 3 days in the desert fun, I was looking at the river bed. The story he told of a river that flowed made me sad to think he was dead. I've been through the desert on a horse with no name. It feels good to be out of the rain. In the desert you can't remember your name, cause there ain't no one for to give you no pain. La 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 la. After 9 days I left the horse run free, cause the desert had turned to sea. There were plants and birds and rocks and things. There were sand and hills and rains. The ocean is a desert with a life underground and a perfect disguise all above. And the cities lie the heart made of ground, and the human will give no love. I've been through the desert on a horse with no name. It felt good to be out of the rain. In the desert you can't remember your name, cause there ain't no one for to give you no pain. La 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 la. Well, thank you for sticking till the end. I hope you're having a wonderful time for this integrating this for this. We I didn't have much experience this year in this specific experience with this Lion Gate. For I'm just asking to be present in the present, and sometimes it is it just things reveal themselves when it is time for things to reveal themselves. For the card of the day is this. I mixed the card, you see, and getting exactly the same card as I got in the French reading. It's a seven of Michael. Okay, once again, it is the card that asks us to let go of fear and doubts. There is a better ways of approaching things. To go about it alone may not be the best solution. Do not neglect the details. So here it is someone where we have been asked not to get into the dark woods, to stay on the light side of the road, and to ask for assistance, ask the angel, ask your guides, ask your creator. Well, thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing. Much is coming about. There will be great transformation, both internally and externally. So let us pray for all the angelic assistance in this transition that we are passing through. Thank you very much. Namaste.